Hello. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. Today's episode of Mixed Media Exploration may contain some material that may not be suitable for all viewers. Crafter guidance is recommended. Hello, everyone. I am very happy to be here. I hope that my ominous opening did not freak anyone out. I'm over here trying really hard not to laugh, actually. But...
Oh, my God.
And I couldn't look at Sylvia because she was busting up in the thing over there. But, all right, so today's mixed media does come with a warning because guess what? I'm going to cover stuff up. What? I know. Last week's discussion made me feel like I was going to be here all by myself. I didn't even think Sylvia would show up. But since you guys are here, I guess you do want to see how this thing... See, there's going to be some... I know it's going to be terrible, but before we get into that, I want to get into it quickly because we've got a lot to cover today and I'm pretty sure it's going to go over the hour. So we'll talk a little bit about how we're going to handle after Crafter Party, what's going to happen, and our giveaway. We've got a giveaway. I don't know if you remember, but last week I said anybody who shows up for this week is going to be entered to win their very own Craft Shack apron. So, I haven't doodled on it. It's just painted. And then I'm going to doodle on it and send it off to the winner. But I wanted to know who wins it first. So what we're going to do is Sylvia is frantically writing down all of your names as you come in to watch. And she'll be doing that throughout the entire episode. And for those who join us afterwards, I'm pretty sure you're going to be watching the replay. If you were here during the live event, then Sylvia's got your name down. If you're watching the replay, that's one of the joys about being here live is that you get to actually win stuff sometimes. So so that's what we're going to be doing. And then as far as after Crafter Party goes, I would love for you guys to join me, but we're not going to actually go off air. I'm going to do this piece until it's done, however long that takes. There's one caveat, though. Sylvia has to go at the top of the hour. So no matter what, she's leaving, whether we're done or not. And before she leaves, she will invite those who would like to come in. And remember, we only have space for 9 people, myself plus 9 others. So the first 9 people to say AKP will have their name down. She will invite you in. If you're not familiar with how that works, this one is going to stay live. So if you don't want to participate on this one and be in the recording, then... You probably don't want to play this time around, but if you are familiar with how it works and everything, then you'll get that box and you'll click accept, etc. So enough of that. Let's switch cameras, and I'm going to switch camera while Sylvia says hello.
Okay, I'm going to get my special looking glass out. You know, we're playing Romper Room today, and I'm going to say hi to Michael, and I see Andrew, and I see Kathy Gillette and Sheila, Vicky Ross, Sarah, Jan Johnson, Clarette, Kim Sim, Candy, Carol, Kim, looks like Semester, Mary, Linda, Lisa, Barbara Clark, Ariane, Michelle, Linda Kay, Kim Sumrak, and Nanette Church are all here today. And we're glad that you're here and hope that you enjoy the completion of the canvas that she's going to do for us today and not, go in too much shock when she starts covering everything up. But, you know, oh well, here you go. Anyways, I'm going to put up today's message.
You're cracking me up over here.
Okay, today's message, need fixing? God's word repairs any damage. For the word of God is living and active. That's from Hebrews 4:12.
All right, I'm not ready yet, so you have to keep talking because I'm trying to get this thing set up. But I can't with the comment on it.
Oh, I took that off, didn't I?
I don't know.
Not. Well, we're going to try and take it off. There we go. I took it off again. Okay.
All right. Let's see. I think I can. Oh, okay. Here we go. I think that's good. Let's click it and save. And yeah. Okay. So I used the watercolor as the. Oh, but it's still got that. Why does it do that? You anger me, camera. So I've got the new camera, thank you to Andrew, but I haven't been able to install it yet. So that's from working on after today's show. If I can get this to work. Oh, because that was still on. Okay, try it now. Ta-da! Okay, and we'll zoom out. Now, for those of you who are joining us for the first time, are you kidding me?
It's back!
Why did it do that? No. Huh. It hates me right now. I don't understand. Oh, now what did it do? All right, guys. This is the last time you'll see this little fit take place. I'll be able to have it all set up ahead of time because Andrew did donate a new camera to the Kraaft Shaak. I just have to get it set up. And I didn't have time because it came last night at like 8 o'clock. So,
wow, that's late. Yeah,
I know. That's what I said. Why isn't it? Let's try this and see what happens. Save. Please do not mess it up. Well, it's got some yellow lines for a little bit, I guess. There's nothing I can do about it. Okay. All right, let's see if we can get through this, even though. Now I'm going to move this apron out of the way so it doesn't get any undesired paint on, but I am putting my apron on to save my shirt. I have ruined more shirts with painting and food than anything else. All right, so for those of you who may not have seen the first episode, I don't know where you've been, but you missed out because we put on all kinds of layers and texture onto this. And if this wasn't solid white, it wouldn't be so bad with those lines. But you can see the hymnal pages, the tech, the stamping, and there's some textured. This is crackle paste over here, and then these circles are just modeling paste. Oh, those lines are going to drive me bananas. And then, of course, we have flowers, and we have some beads on. And then I went over the whole thing with gesso. So now you're all caught up. And what I did forget to do was fill my water bottle. So we're going to do that real quick because I need water for this fun part here. Any comments you want to bring up while I'm filling up with water?
Yeah, I'm trying to frantically write down all the names.
Oh.
That's okay. No,
you have the important thing going on, which is, you know, make sure a winner gets drawn. So that's your big job today.
Oh, and everybody is starting to say AKP too.
Oh, whoa. My bad on that one, huh?
And I did. People are saying thank you to Andrew for the camera. That was very, very sweet of you, Andrew.
Yeah,
to do
those
that.
Of you yeah. who are taking the drawing class, you are actually going to be very happy with Andrew's purchase because it's going to change the drawing class dramatically or dramatically, either way, or drastically. I don't know. All right, I've got another spray bottle here, and this one we are putting in isopropyl alcohol. 91%. Putting that into this one. I don't need to do too much. It is kind of a mist, so that's not good for my breathing, but some things you do for the sake of art. All right, put the cap on and put that away. Okay, I meant to do all that beforehand, and I apologize that I did not. I was busy getting kicked out of the hangout, so.
Yeah, we had problems.
Okay.
So if that happens, people, just stay put. She'll be back.
Yeah, don't anybody go nowhere till we're done, all right? Yeah. All right, so one of the things, I need another green. I've got some different types of what is this stuff called? Acrylic paint. All right, so we've got different types and different colors. So I'm going to be playing with PBO Studio Acrylics in the Dyna line, which means they have an iridescent two-tone to them. Dina Wakely's Heavy Body Acrylic Paints. We're going to be playing with those. And then I've got some cheaper Apple Barrel paints and Kraaft paint. This is Kraaft paint. So basically we've got, the only thing I don't have is like golden. I do have Liquitex over there and a couple of golden paints, but I'm not using those today. So we're just going to have some fun. So the first thing is figuring out how to be able to show you guys the bottom of what I want to do. Oh, those lines are driving me crazy, Sylvia.
The thing is I'm using a yellow marker. Name, so.
Something just happened and it all shifted again.
Yeah, it did.
So hang on. Let's see if we can get this to do something. Wow, that's really weird. I wonder if my camera's decided to go out since I have a backup.
Yeah, probably.
That would be ideal.
It's probably mad and it's letting you know. So.
Yeah. How rude. Look, no yellow lines.
Well, there's a little, but not that bad.
Okay, don't nobody breathe. Okay. Yeah. All right. So here we go. I've got, I'm just going to be putting on some different paints. And I know that it seems like we're going to be covering all this up, but that's what I have, the spray bottle, and I have some alcohol to add some really cool texturing. And we're going to be playing. We're just going to have some fun here. So I've got green, which is, this is the bottom of the canvas. Oh, I forgot to put on my lotion. Too late now.
The stuff that keeps your hands clean?
Well, I just have this Gold Bond softening lotion. It creates a really nice barrier. It's not perfect, but it usually keeps me from turning all colors. if I remember the key important part, which is to put it on before I play with the paint. Okay, so just some water here. And again, with that alcohol or that acrylic paint. Okay, now I want you to see that you can still see the texture through it. I'm just adding layers of color. Make sure I don't grab that one by accident. I mean, when I want it, but holly branch, lime green, holly branch. Let's go with the holly branch.
Apparently there's some issues with you pausing out there, and it's several people that are saying it.
Yeah, I don't know. We're having such a nightmare of internet problems. Who knows what it could be? We were having it before we even went live, so.
And Andrew says that if the little lines come back again, we can pretend that we're looking through Venetian blinds. We're peeking.
Yes. Everybody's peeking at me. Exactly. I like that. Well, I don't like everybody peeking at me, but I do like that. That's the attitude we're going to have. Okay. So basically what I want to do is add the green in here for the appearance of a ground. Hopefully that's what's coming across. Let's see. It's hard to do this upside down. Can I just say that right now? Go back in here with a little bit more green over here. And I could use, you know, like, what are those things called? Paint brushes? I could do that, I suppose, but.
Hey, anybody can use a paintbrush.
Exactly. Yeah. So now I don't know if this is going to be seen on camera because of the ridiculous thing that our camera is doing, but you can still see the texture through it.
Yes, you can.
You can still see the paper back there and everything. So we're going to let that part dry. And I recommend you do the edges as well if you're playing along with this and you have, you know, you do the edges as well because you don't want them to be naked. Unless you want them to be naked, that's different, I guess, but I'm just going to use some lime green and kind of go around. I know you probably can't see what I'm doing here per se, but I need to be able to see it. Just trust me here, people.
Trust me.
So there was lots of discussion last week about covering up, and the warning sign that I showed at the beginning was totally inspired because of an email I got from Linz. You guys see her in here as Miss Brewer sometimes. I don't know if she's here today.
I'm not seeing her in here.
Okay, well, she'll watch the replay, so we'll say hi, Linz. But she sent an email that made it very clear to me that she actually mentioned a warning sign for something else she was watching, but I thought, you know what, that's maybe I should put up a disclaimer so that people know what
I
you see.
I thought it was hysterical.
I know you did. That's why I couldn't look at you while I was saying it. All right, I've got a baby wipe here. And I'm just going to pull some of this color up a little bit more, and it's going to make some of it go off. Like, we're going to, oh, you can't see any of this, can you? Basically, what I'm doing is I'm creating a base coat of color. And I don't want to remove too much. I just want to make sure that I'm getting all the color where I want it to be. Love baby wipes for this purpose because it spreads it out as well as thins it down a little bit. So now you can really see, I don't know if you guys can or not, but there's still, all that stuff is in the background. The layers are still there, I promise.
I like how it brings out the texture or texture of the modeling paste.
Yes, I do too. It's kind of cool. All right, so now we're going to go to the top with blue. And again, a huge canvas, so it's very difficult to utilize this properly on camera. I'm zoomed out as far as I can, and we're up as high as we can get it. It might help me to have paintbrushes for this, I think, because I just can't quite reach. So I've just got some Dina Wakely, some PBO, and let's add this one in here too, why not? Whee! Okay, and we're gonna spray it with some water. So we really want it to move and drip. And some of this paint drips a lot better than some of the others. See how that Kraaft paint reacts to the water? And the Dina just sort of sits there, but that Kraaft paint, ooh, does it move? I need a larger paintbrush for this, I think. Or my fingers, I'm not sure which. So my whole purpose for this piece was to bring spring into my home. And I've mentioned in the last episode how much I love this time of year. And I really wanted to provide myself a piece that basically says how I feel about this time of year. And I think the bright colors, after having such a long winter, I mean, our winter starts the same time for everybody, I know that, but our winter, our snow all over the ground started November, like early November. And in the 12 years that I've lived here in Montana, I've never experienced that much snow and for so long. So I've got a lot of the, like, cabin fever going on, I guess you'd say. Need more paint down here. And so I really felt like I needed to do something to brighten this place up, to brighten myself up even, because you know how that affects your mood. And with the surgery recovery and not going the way I intended it to and everything, it's been a little dark around here, gray. In the last few days, it's been even grayer because having more winter storms. And that kind of thing. So, all right, let's get some more stuff going on. I want to see this drip. Let's add the alcohol. See what cool. The heck happens. Why not? Ooh, look at that. That's cool.
Yeah. What, are you getting molting?
Are you able to see that?
Uh-uh.
This is like, here, watch right here.
Oh, yeah. I like that.
Yeah, me too. And I like it dripping down like that. Where did the brush go? There it is. I'm going to sop this part up here because I don't really necessarily want that. It's going to be, I've hidden my paper towels behind the piece. All right, paper towels. Ooh, that's cool. You see what it did? I don't know if you guys can see this. Man, this is not fair. Nothing's working out today the way I want it to.
Michelle Dees is agreeing with you. She says, yeah, she also wants bright colors and spring.
And spring. All right. Yeah. So we all are going to sign the I Want Spring petition.
Yes.
All right. Now, I could just leave where I sprayed alone, so that way that effect will be cool. But I don't have patience for that. So today we're going to just mush it in and let what happens happen. I love this. This is so cool.
Michael Daniels is just like, I love alcohol.
yeah, we know. We know.
Oh, Lord.
Speaking of, we have a game show going on this Friday. I don't know if anybody's familiar with the game show, but if you haven't watched it yet, you've been missing out on one of the funniest things on the internet. And Michael Daniels is the host. We're going to play Plus Word on Friday night. So those of you who, if you follow me on whatever that's called, G+, I always post about it. So you'll be able to see it there. But if you don't follow me, follow Michael, because that's where you'll definitely never miss a beat, even if I'm not on the show. Because believe it or not, he does do it with that. He does the show without me as well. I didn't think about what I was saying.
How
there.
Dare he?
I know. And Andrew's there. Okay, this is a good base. I like this. I'm going to rub some of this back, which kind of bugs the crap out of me sometimes when I see people do this, because it's like, why did you just waste all that product? But it's too heavy here, so I want to make sure that I have that open a little bit more. Oh, the texture is really cool. Can you guys see that? I don't know if it's coming off on screen or not.
We can see the stuff that's done with modeling paste and then your flowers and everything.
All right. I'm going to try camera one more time now that it's not totally white. Maybe that'll help. Of course, if I keep messing with it and it goes black, we're in big trouble, but...
It's like, okay. We can't see the book paper and stuff that you put on, though, or Hammonholes, I think it was. Yeah.
I promise. All right, let's see if we can mess this up some more. Oh, look at those colors. That's way closer to what we have on the canvas.
Oh, really? Oh, that really changed. Yeah, yeah.
All right, now... I do not understand what is going on with my... I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, it's very bright turquoise, and there's lots of green down below. But hopefully you can see there's still book text under there. The stamping is visible.
Just vaguely. I'm sure that an Instagram picture will show it much better.
All right, fine. I'll do that right now since...
Okay,
today's about having fun, right?
Yeah. Well, you're going to take that picture. Yes, there's been another question about the AKP. We are going to do a pseudo AKP, which means Heather's going to continue this broadcast for as long as it takes, which means it'll probably go over the hour. And so if you're interested in coming into the film strip, and we can only have 9 total in the film strip, please put AKP in the comment section here so I can make sure that I send you out an invite.
And don't forget, you must be signed in with Google in order for that to work.
And you must be signed in with Google in order for that to work.
All right. And I just posted to Instagram. And I didn't hit the Facebook thing. Sorry about that. Next one will be on Facebook, too.
For anybody who's new to joining us with an AKP, just when Heather gives me the go, I'll be sending out an invite, and you'll get a little invite that says, do you want to join the film strip? And you just click it and follow the directions. But like she said, you have to be on Google Plus in order for that to work.
And you don't have to have a camera, because we're going to keep it on the project here. It won't flip over to you. So if you haven't done your makeup, don't need to fret. If your hair, Michael, needs to be fixed, it's okay. You'll be fine. All right. I think that's good enough for our first coat. I think I don't love this drip right here, so I need to move this.
We need to see you. Okay. It's not on. Okay.
So I have to move this because I don't like that it dripped down into this area right here, but I'm pretty sure that's all going to get covered in my next thing anyway. Ooh, I'm liking that. I think I'm going to wipe back more because I like that. Wow, that's cool. Look at that. Can you see that? Oh, man. You better be able to see that. No? What is the deal today, camera and internet and stuff? Don't they know we have something really cool we're doing? I'm amazed at how well these things are all staying on. Like, I'm not being very gingerly at all, and it's all staying right where it is supposed to be. Okay, let's hit this so it doesn't move anymore. So while the acrylic paint is wet, anything that I put on it, like more acrylic paint or spray it with the water bottle or whatever, is going to keep it moist and keep it moving. So that's why it's much whiter here, because it basically wiped off the green as the blue came on and the water and whatnot. So if I use my whatever this thing's called, heat tool, I'm drying it. Now, acrylic paint doesn't like heat. It's plastic, you know, so it's not a good thing to do. But I'm just trying to get it dry to the touch. I'm not trying to, you know, heat it like you would with, say, embossing powder or something. Ooh, embossing powder, that would be a good idea. Got a lot of paint right here. Oh, go ahead.
While that's drying, I'd like to put up this comment from Beth. This is from Beth Brown. She says, Heather's Instagram feed is one of my absolute favorites. I agree, Beth. I really enjoy looking at what she posts up there because she sure puts some pretties up there.
Well, thanks, guys. I have to tell you, I recently discovered that you can actually be notified when someone posts on Instagram. And I honestly did not know you could do that all this time. And it's been really cool because several of you who watch the show have an Instagram page, and every time I come across one, I'm like, ooh, I'll follow that person. And every time you post, I get notified. It's been lots of fun. I would love to tell you how to do that, but I don't remember. It's on there. It has something to do with the three dots by someone's picture, by like the picture that they posted. That's all I can think of right now. I don't know. Okay, so I think this is pretty well dry enough. I mean, these flowers are not, but we're not going to mess with them right now anyway, so it's okay. Even if they blends, I'm okay with that because there's going to be a lot of color on this. So again, let me just see if you can see it. Oh, you aggravate me, camera, with those lines and stuff. Can you see that paper? You can see that paper, right? It's still there. Yeah, you don't see it, do you? Okay. All right. Well, let's go in with some bright springy colors. I've got pink and a chunk of pink. This is the thing I don't like about these cheapy things, but it really has less to do with it being cheap paint and more to do with it being how I use it. I'm not very clean with my paint stuff, you know. I'm not very clean with my products at all, I guess, to be honest with you. All right, let's see how to do this. Add some yellow as well. All right. You got to be freaking out by now. I can't believe we haven't heard any, like, what in the world are you doing?
Well, you did give that disclaimer, so.
Yeah, that's okay. True.
So I think that.
Oh, that God. Helped?
Yeah, look how springy that looks. Oh, my gosh.
All right, now I have it on an angle so that you can see more of it, and it's dripping quite a bit. So I think I'm going to have to bring it off of the trying to get this yellow and the pink to mix in some places, which is kind of cool, but it's also kind of muddy there. Let's go with some more yellow, but we're going to use Dina's heavy body yellow instead. And I'm almost out. Oh, that looks almost like mustard. That's perfect. Not. Wow, look at that. Over the top of the blue. Can you see that down here? Looks very green, huh?
Very green.
Very green. Which is cool. We don't care. Mix it all up. And it's just water that I sprayed. If you're wondering what I sprayed there, it's just water. Okay, now I don't know. We're going to have a conversation while we're doing this. I don't know if when you're doing mixed media, sometimes things turn into kind of a mess, like bizarro land mess. And I've found over the last several years of doing this that there seems to be, and I know you can't see what I'm doing there. It's just, I'm just moving the color around. There seems to be a little bit of ugly stage. You ever noticed an ugly stage to your work before it gets to the part where you're like, oh, okay, there we go. That's what I was going for. Or maybe it's just me. I don't know. I seem to go through a lot of ugly stage first. But in this case, I knew that whatever I put down is going to be the background coloring. Leave that one. I like how that one is. I know that we're not going to have a lot of this show in the end, so okay.
There's some discussion about the time that this started, and I just have to remind everybody that, yeah, Saturday night we did switch to daylight savings time here in the United States. And for those of you watching in other countries, I think other countries go on daylight savings time too.
Yeah, but not at the same time.
Yeah, probably not at the same time. So in answer to your question, Anamati, yeah, it probably was an hour earlier according to what your time is. Because Heather, in springtime, we spring forward and then fall back in the fall. And so Heather and I are always on the same time zone until she goes on daylight, and then Arizona doesn't go on daylight. So I align with San Diego. I align with California. And so Heather is an hour ahead of me. So,
yeah, and it kind of stinks. I grew up my whole life in Arizona and never had to deal with this junk. And then I moved here with little kids. And I got to tell you, whoever did daylight savings didn't have little kids. Like, daylight savings would be great for, and oh boy, is that a topic of discussion as to why they do it. But anyway, nobody said, hey, let's ask the moms and how they're going to work with the toddlers. Because good luck telling your kid at 10:30 at night that it's bedtime. Because it's still bright outside. It's really ridiculous, actually. Okay, I've got more alcohol here. And I think...
Oh, that's going to be interesting. Apparently, Anamati goes at the end of March, and other places, Andrew was saying, in Europe, they haven't all changed yet. So,
yeah.
I think it was like a year or so ago, they decided to move it up for whatever reason. And I don't understand the reasoning, because I always was told that it was because of the farmers, so they had more daylight, and that's not really true. I actually think it's for the oil industry, because they, during daylight savings time, they make $1 billion more. Yeah.
Well, that's what I was just going to say. That is a very hot topic as to why, you know, energy savings and all kinds of reasons. But good luck finding the real reason. I think it just has to do with money. It always has to do with money.
Yeah, they did a study for energy savings, and they found that during the whole time frame of daylight savings time in the United States, energy increased 0.05%.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
But consumption of gasoline was off the charts, because people do things when there's daylight out. So
exactamundo. All right, we're going to dry this again. This is the reason why we're going over today, because there's a lot of drying. I can't just keep moving. Now, if I was doing this without the camera on, I'd be one in a larger space, workspace, so I could actually work on this better. But B, I would also have another project. I would set this one down and work on my other project and go as far as I could on that one. And then if this one was ready, or if I was done with that and this one was dry enough, then I would continue on with this one. And if not, I would move on to another project. Because for me, this is how I do it. When I'm working on a project, I have a zone that I'm in. And while I'm in that zone, I don't really want to stop and do anything. That includes eat. I really don't. I don't want to do much of anything, to be honest, because what tends to happen is I lose the zone. So I like to do multiple pieces at once. It's just the best way for me to do what I like to do. I added too much yellow. I don't really like how much yellow is on this thing, but it's a base coat. It's a base coat.
I love it. I love the yellow. It's so bright and sunny.
In some places, it's kind of gray. But you can't tell that on screen, so I shouldn't even say anything, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Oh. Let's see here.
Linz is here. Hi, Linz.
Hello. And I did try to say in the blog post that had the supply list for last week and this week, I did try to say that we were starting, you know, be aware of daylight savings, but sorry.
And just to remind everybody about, for those that are joining us late too, we will be doing an AKP. Heather's going to continue the show past the hour because we think that it probably will go over. And just put in the comments AKP and I'll get your name circled and invite you in. We can only have 9 people in the film strip at any given time, but you can hang around and watch. And if you want to come in the film strip, you have to use Google+.
Right. So if you're signing in with Facebook, it's awesome to be able to watch it with Facebook, but it won't let you come into the film strip. That's what that means. So I decided since some of those flowers are just not drying yet, I'm going to move on to a different portion here. So ooh, I like that.
What purple are you using, Heather? Is that okay, Dina Wakeling.
Blackberry Violet, Dina Wakeling.
Oh, that one. That one's a pretty one.
It is a pretty one. And you can really see that doily popping out now. It's kind of, I don't know if what you guys can see. I should just give up on that thought process and tell you I'm going to take an Instagram picture or something and let you see it. All right, I think if this yellow is dry, then I think I can move over because you don't want to mix yellow and purple together. It is not pretty. You can go over the top of yellow because, you know, it's acrylic paint. It's not going to mix once it's dry, but if it isn't dry, ooh, nasty. So what I'm doing with this piece is it's going to be kind of abstract, not kind of. It's going to be very abstract until the end when it will have a little bit more sensical. I don't know what word I want to use here. I just know I'm making stuff up. So something. It will do something. This is a little alcohol. I don't know if the alcohol is doing what I want it to do. Whee! That's kind of cool. Let's go all the way across with that, though.
I like how it looks one color on one side, another color on the other side.
That's kind of why I wanted to go across, so yeah. And I'm loving this over here on this texture. Ooh. But we're going to wipe it back, kind of glaze it. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Glazing medium.
Oh, there you go.
Hey, you know what I just realized? I don't have a bucket of water for my brushes. Not smart. Really, I'm just kind of going wherever it feels to me. I know it doesn't make any sense. It's not going to, I promise, for a little while. okay? That much I can promise. Oh, look at that.
That's good, yeah. Andrew's saying that Heather delights in making up words that Michael can't spell. Yep.
He's right about that.
Sue Clark just said, I see my EKG pattern.
Yeah, it does kind of look that way. Okay, here, let's see. Can you see what I did? Oh, come on. Work with me, technology. Can you see that?
Love all the texture that we can see. I love the different colors that it took. It's very, very pretty.
Yeah, one color across, and it looks like there's red and all sorts of things going on here. So I'm going to take this very purple paper towel that's still got some moisture on it. See what I can do over here. Oh, you guys, I'm trying so hard to stay on camera for you. So remember we talked about that ugly stage, right? We did mention that.
Yeah. I'm not seeing anything ugly here. I'm liking what my eyes are seeing. Well, that's different. Like Michael says, nice paintbrushes you got there, lady.
Yeah, I know. And speaking of paintbrushes, now would be a good time for a comment because I have to get a bucket of water.
Fine. Okay, I just said them all. See my EKG pattern, nice paintbrushes, words. Okay.
All right. Okay. All right. I'm good now. Thanks, ma'am. All right, let's throw some orange in here. I'm just got some orange on the end of my paintbrush and am going to go over. If you're listening and not watching, you miss out on a lot of stuff here. But basically what I'm doing, let's see if we can do this. I'm just kind of hitting the highlights of these petals on these flowers.
I like when you do that because it really brings out the details.
Yeah, that's kind of where I'm going with it. I think mm-hmm. that it needs something that says, I have ridges, but they don't have to all be one color.
It's not just ruffles that has ridges.
Exactly.
Right.
See how it's not drying over here, though, because I have a lot of paint, so some of this is going to get a little muddy, but that's okay.
Boy, that really brought out those ridges very nicely. Very nice.
A little bit of texture there. Let's see if you can see what I'm doing.
Very pretty. I do have to say that Kim, she said hand barrier cream does help. Well, Heather kind of knew that, but she forgot to put it on. So
yeah. Well, I had it literally right here.
Yeah, there you go. Sometimes you got to open the cap of the tube.
Yeah, it's about application, and yeah. Apparently I didn't do that part. Oh, me likesy.
Yeah, I'm loving the colors in this. Holy cow. It's like spring. Spring bursts forth.
All right. So now sometimes when I'm doing mixed media, I'm thinking, man, you're just making a big old mess and you're using a whole bunch of product and it doesn't even really make sense. But I promise you I'm going somewhere with this. I promise. That's why we're going to go over the hour, because I really do want you to see where my vision is headed. I thought about doing a third Kraaft It Live for this. But honestly, once I get going, I didn't want to stop. So I kind of thought we'd do like a bonus Kraaft It Live in the middle of the week, month, whatever this is called, month. And we would extend it out beyond what we normally do. And the other thing is we're giving away a Kraaft Shaak apron to one lucky viewer who's watching us live. This gives you way more opportunity to watch live because a lot of people come in after the show is over and watch. And their names, at least until the top of the hour when Sylvia's here. Maybe I'll be able to enlist somebody in AKP to actually take the names of the other folks, maybe. I don't know. That'd be kind of cool. Unexpectedly get to be a part of the drawing when they expect they won't usually ever get to be a part of the live show. We like to mix things up around here, you know. Okay, that's looking a little bit fun. Let's just put this in here.
We've got a discussion going about liquid gloves and the different types of liquid that you can apply to your hands. And and Andrew, you know, is just saying, you know, open the tube first or you apply the sandpaper later. And then Lynn's was saying, like a belt sander.
Yeah, I've actually a couple weeks ago I felt like I needed to use it. Actually, it was last week because we glued all these things down. Boy, howdy, did I feel like I needed a belt sander after that.
I like Tim Holtz's scrubber. It's a scrubby. I like that. That really does help to take stuff off.
Okay. And where do you get those? Are they available at like regular?
Mm-hmm. I got mine at Michael's. They're at Michael's and Joann's and stuff. They're not always available, you know.
But it's not like you have to special order something like that per se. Not usually.
It's a gray thing, and it. I don't know. It feels like a. What's that thing that you use for your feet?
A pumice stone? Yeah.
Except it's not as rough as that.
Oh, okay. Interesting. All right, that was just too much yellow in there for me. Wow, it's starting to look like a mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. That's interesting. When I look up at the camera and what I see, not at the camera, at the screen. All right, let's work on the grass down here a little bit while that dries.
Okay, while you're doing that, I want to put up this comment from Lynn's over. She's in the UK. She says, I can't get barrier cream in the UK, so I just pretend it's some form of illness if I go out.
Oh, I've never told you the story about the wedding we went to. Oh, my husband, he cracks me up. Okay, so I had been working on the, do you remember the piece that I did? It was the poppies. Actually, of course you do, Sylvia, because you have it hanging in your house. But the
yes, I do.
Red poppies in blue sky. Turquoise sky, that piece, we did a whole bunch of little round circles with red dye. And at the end of that show, my husband says, well, we need to go get ready for it was a rehearsal dinner that they were having. And so he says, you know, we need to go get ready for that. Are you going to wash up? So I did. I went and I washed up and my hands were still like beet red. And I had all these like thick blotches all over the place. And he goes, so are you going to go wash up? I said, I did. I washed up. He was very unhappy. He didn't even want me to go. He almost left me home.
Embarrassed to be seen with your artist hands?
Pretty much, yeah. The noise. All right, so I've got a dark green here.
What are we going to do with that? You're making me nervous now.
All right. And then I've got some mixed, what is this stuff called? Glazing medium.
Okay.
And I'm going to mix that in with the green.
Okay, I'll go back and read the disclaimer now.
All right, so this is basically a glaze now. And we're going to go back to the grassy knoll here.
Okay.
And we're just going to kind of hit all over this thing here. Let's see. Now, Dina Wakely glazing medium will allow you to do this technique. There's a couple of them. Golden has a great glazing fluid. That one you need to let it dry like a minute and a half or something, I think. With Dina's, is it Dina? Yeah, it's Dina.
Yeah.
Wakely. Yeah. Hers does not seem to take that long. Like if you leave it that, you're done. So you want to leave it maybe a minute, maybe less than that.
That's going to be cool because it's going to highlight those, you know, the texture that you have in there.
Yeah, that's our plan anyway. So we've got some baby wipes fresh out of the bucket. I think while I wait, I'm going to clean my fingers. Is it able
yes,
to see?
Yes, we can
this?
See.
Okay. Okay. I just realized I had this terrible light that might be the problem. I don't know if that's what's been causing those lines or not. Man, I tell you, there's a lot to this whole video mixed media live stuff. All right. Starting to dry, so it's time to get in there. So you don't wait too long, man. I'm telling you right now, you don't wait too long. I just really wanted that spring green grass. I've got myself a clean spot on the baby wipe here. Another clean spot.
Lynn's was saying.
Oh, something about baby wipes.
Well, she says, no, there needs to be a book on what Medium does and include the official and unofficial uses, i.e. gloss gel can be used as bikini wax. And everybody's going, yikes, or, you know, like, ouch.
I've not heard that one. I've not heard that one. All right. So there's the glazed bottom. That's cool, right?
Yeah, it is. It's very cool.
But I really want some more of this to be back in there. So we're going to, again, with my hands. Yeah, I really liked how it had some iridescence in there, but I didn't like how it covered up without giving the texture the shine that it did. Now with that glaze, you can see all the texture of the book pages and everything. I don't know if you can, but I sure can.
Yeah, there you go.
Basically, I just want it to be like hit and miss with this gold green in here, which I don't know if you can see that or not.
Oh, now you can when you tilt it. Yes, we can see it.
I'm really mad at my equipment today. All right, let's see if I can get. All right, it's time for an Instagram update. Okay. And this time I will include it on Facebook. For those of you not on Instagram, you can go to my Facebook page. Hard part is it's not always public, so I don't know. Let's do a couple. We're going to do a couple.
I can't wait to see what that looks like on Instagram. Well, Lynn started quite a conversation over here about the bikini wax. And
it doesn't sound like Lynn's at all.
No, no, no. And Andrew said, I never understood why a woman wants to wax a bikini.
I agree with Andrew. Yeah. I don't understand it either.
Yeah.
I can't even wear the darn things, let alone wax one. All right. There we go. I got three pictures up over there for you.
Okay.
Okay. Now, again, we wait for it to dry. Wowzers.
We're waiting.
Yeah, I thought I'd be much further along than this. Boy, adding paint takes up a lot of time, but so does the camera issues really took up a lot of time too, but.
Very pretty. I checked it out on Instagram. It's very, very pretty.
All right. I'm going to do one more picture because you guys can't see the whole thing. So I'm going to do one more picture. It'll also be on Twitter if you can't see on Facebook or Instagram. How about that?
Okay. That sounds good. Oh, is there flooding going on? Christian was asking Beth if she's far from the flooding.
Yeah, there's been lots of flooding in the south, but I didn't
From
know
the snow
Texas.
melt or
I didn't
rain?
know
I mean, I
Texas.
didn't know that.
I thought there was lots of rain going on, but I didn't know Texas was involved.
Let us know, Beth.
Okay. All right, I think I am ready to go to the next stage.
You know what this looks like to me? This looks like Hawaii to me. This looks like,
Really?
yeah, Kauai. Looks like the mountains of Kauai with all the beautiful Hawaiian flowers and the green, and it's very, very pretty.
Well, that is totally unintentional. Okay. I don't know if you guys can see, you can't see this because of where it is. Okay, hold on. Look at the bottom here. Let's see if this will.
Ooh. Yeah, we can see the PBO. We can
I
see that.
know. Look at
Yeah,
that's cool,
that looks
huh?
good. Yeah.
All right. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is get out my Stabilo all pencil and my sketch. Now let me explain. I am in church and it hits me. I want to do a cross and I want it to be standing on a hill and I want it to be leaning backwards. So I started with this one and it was leaning too forward. So I did this one. Yeah, that's what I want. That is what's going to go here. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is start with this. Inspiration hits you anywhere, people. So the first thing I'm going to start with is wet paint all over there. Okay, is this line, this shadow line, can you see that line back there?
Yes.
That is a straight down line. So I'm going to start up here and I'm just going to take it all the way down straight. Even though the piece is leaning, this part of it is straight.
Okay, we're coming up on three on the hour. We got 3 more minutes in the actual for real portion of this before we start doing
For real
AKB.
portion.
Yeah.
It's also the portion before Sylvia decides to leave us as
Yeah.
well.
So I'm just going to throw out the names that I know of that have said they want AKB. We've got Michelle Dees, we've got Nanette, we have Linda K. Murphy, we have Jazzy, we have Christian, Beth Brown, and Anomati. So if there's anybody else, please let me know.
And I don't know how many you said because I wasn't counting, but we can only have nine.
That's 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 right now.
Okay, gotcha. All right, so I'm using my Stabilo All pencil because one, it writes on everything. So that's first. So it'll write right over the top of this paint, right over the top of all this texture, everything. It's awesome. The second thing is it's also water soluble. So when I go to do the next step, it will sort of, let's see, we're gonna make this just a little bit more of an angle, not too much, but a little bit. And this part parallel with that. This part kind of goes down just a little bit more, not as sharp, not as sharp. Heather, calm it down. All right, so this is pretty much what I think I'm going for here. Yep, looking good. Okay.
I love the sound.
Do you? I thought it would be a
I
little bit
do.
annoying. Okay. All right, so now here's a tip for your shadows. Whenever you're doing shadows, this line here is the same angle as this line here and this line here. It'll also be the same as this line here. So no matter how this looks, that's you keep those angles the same and it'll look great to your eye. It's also the same angle over here. It's also the same width and thickness until it gets down to the bottom. Here it's a lot thicker down here. But so now these, even though this tips up and back, this line and this line are parallel, meaning they're the same on the same length, right? The same line. keep that in mind whenever you're doing something that has shadows. And you should be okay. All right, this is a lot taller than I think it needs to be. So here's what's awesome about this. Watch this. Baby wipes. As long as my paint up here is dry, I can just remove my lines like an eraser. And we're golden. Yeah, that's much better. Much shorter, I think. I like it like that. Make sure it's dry before I go drawing any more on there, because I don't want it to be a muddy mess.
Okay, that's while you're drawing that, I'm just going to reiterate. Yes, I got that Michelle Dees and Beth Brown dropped out of the AKP because they had other things that came up. So that leaves, we have Lisa Conway, Nanette, Linda K. Murphy, Jane, Christian, and Anna Mati. So if anybody else wants to join, please let me know. And yes, you can still stay here. You don't have to. When we say join, that means come into the film strip and talk to us.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that. So if you're not joining the film strip, you can still stay and watch. That's why we're doing it different today. So we're not going to go away or turn it off. We're going to keep on going. Those who come into the AKP will just get to ask the questions in chat. That was the whole point. So.
And I'm going to start inviting now because we're at 12:01 and I've
Thank
got
you, ma'am.
To go. Okay,
Thank
so
you, ma'am.
Lisa Conway, you're getting invited.
Okay, and I have got white gesso because I don't have any more heavy body white acrylic paint, which is what I was anticipating using. And I've got a paintbrush. And I'm going to start wherever I have those lines, and I'm just going to pull it out. Now, it's going to react with that Stabilo All Pencil, which is totally fine with me. It's going to be part of the whole effect of this. And I'm going to cover up the whole background except for where the cross is.
Oh, bye-bye, Claret.
And to those who can't stick around, you know it's recorded. You can always come back and watch the rest of it anytime. And if you're wondering who won the apron, we are going to do the drawing later. Probably tomorrow, we'll have announcement tomorrow because Sylvia's got stuff she needs to do, so we can't do it yet. Okay, so now.
Michael's too funny. Sylvia's the best host ever. Hostess. Hostess with the mostest, Michael. Yeah. Thank you. That's just too sweet.
I know, and I have to be without her because she's leaving me, the nerve.
Well, it's my granddaughter's birthday, and I've got a lot of things I have to do, so.
And everybody sing happy birthday to Maddie because I guess she's allowed.
Yeah, she's a little sweetheart. Okay, so I have sent to Lisa and to Linda Kay and Jane and Christian and Anna Mati.
All right. Thank you very much, and thanks to those of you who are joining.
Okay, so if they don't come in, are you going to remember?
No, I won't be able to do it either, so it's fine.
No.
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
If they don't come
Alrighty.
In, they aren't able to make it, they can just stay out there and watch.
Now, if I hang up, it's not going to affect anything,
nope,
right?
No, you're fine.
Okay, goodbye, everybody. Have fun.
Bye, Sylvia. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thanks for joining us today. It was great. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, so we're still here, even though she's gone. We're still here. And I don't know if you can see what I'm doing because it's kind of turned into a real mess. But basically what I'm trying to do is leave white where around the cross, leave what's in the cross totally open and unaffected. And then I want it to kind of fade out to where all the rest of that color is. So it is going to go over some of this stuff. And that's why we had the disclaimer at the beginning. And if you guys who are in here with me, I can't look up to see who it is, but if you are in here with me and you see a comment you want to, you know, mention, please do. If you even want to speak to me, that'd be great as well. I wouldn't mind.
Hi. Hi, Heather.
Hello, hello. Okay, I can't see who it is. You guys are going to have to
Christian.
Tell me. Oh, hi, Christian. How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
I appreciate
you
coming.
I love how it's... Will we get more of the blue back around where you put the white?
Say it again.
For the blue, will you add more blue to the sections that you added the white?
Nope, I'm not going to add any more color after this, except on the flowers. The flowers are the only thing that's going to get color when this white part is all done.
Okay.
And I did forget to mention that if you do have like a TV on in the background or anything like that, if you'd please mute yourself so that way it doesn't mess up our copyright infringement on YouTube, that'd be great.
Done.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ah. I missed where you started putting on the white. I was having a little trouble getting in, but...
Well, don't freak out. I put a warning at the beginning of the show, so nobody's allowed to hate me. I was clear.
And I missed the warning at the beginning of the show because my computer was, I don't know what it was doing this morning, but it took forever.
Hey, for you know what? We've been having all kinds of technical problems, so it might not just be your computer, I'm saying.
Yeah, it could be other stuff happening, eh?
I don't know. It sure seems that way here anyway.
Andrew has to run.
Bye, Andrew. Bye to anybody who has to run. I don't mean for you guys to stick around if you can't, but, you know, you can always come back and watch. Just remember, come back to the one-hour mark.
Do you know if people are waiting to get in?
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
They got all their invitations. If they're having trouble, they should say so in the chat, I suppose. But
okay.
But there's not much I can do unless we want to take the time to worry about it.
Yeah. No, I was just going to say, if there are people waiting, I can always get out as long as I can see what's going on. I just don't want to miss what you're doing.
No, we have plenty of room for people to come in if they wanted to. So if they got an invitation, it's on their end to come
all
in.
All right.
So all now right. I did forget to mention that anywhere there's a shadow, I am going to go over that with the night color from Dina Wakely, which is like a super dark blue.
Okay. Ooh. See, until you turned it upside down, I couldn't see the hill.
Hey, I'm trying. This thing is huge, man. In my workspace, I thought was big, but it's not big enough for this particular canvas. So bad choice on my part, but I really wanted this to be very impactful.
It is.
We'll see. We'll see. Okay, I've got a baby wipe. I'm going to fix this little line I messed up here. Okay.
Brett says she's still watching the chat and that the white is awesome.
Awesome. Oh, okay. So far nobody wants to murder me or string me up or anything, huh?
No, not yet.
So far.
Not yet.
Kim says she isn't going to cover it all up, is she?
I know. The panic ensues, doesn't it? I want to really make sure that this is very white around the cross because that's the important part to me. And you know what? I don't even care if it's perfect and straight or anything anymore. I don't, because I'm loving how this is turning out, so... Now notice how the gesso does not fully cover this purple over here. That's one of those incredible colors from Dina. It's much stronger pigment than... If I'd have used the magenta, forget about it. Magenta never gets covered. Nothing you can do to cover magenta, it seems like, but... I don't know what you guys can see or can't see, so help me out if you need me to move or something, please. Okay, so I am going to go over some of these flowers, especially anything that's near the cross here. We're going to let this stuff dry a little bit before I keep smearing it. So what do you think about the extended hour of Kraaft It Live, guys? Now, don't everybody talk at once.
I think it's a good idea.
Cool.
Is this just something that became available that set it up this way?
No, I've just always done an hour-long show because I didn't think anybody would ever stick around long enough. But in the past, I've done these where I've chopped up the project, you know, so that it went like a whole hour three or four times. And it's very hard to get back into the project a whole week later.
Oh, yeah.
So I really didn't want to do that with this particular piece this time around. And I'd hoped, and I was going to say something about it last week, but I didn't really think about it too much, I guess, last week. I started thinking about it afterwards, going, there's no way we're going to finish this in an hour. It's just not possible.
Well, I like the way you're doing it. I think this is cool.
Well, Jane, you're the only voice I care about right now, so that's perfect.
There you go. We've taken care of that.
All right, good.
I love how it's coming out as well.
Yay! Thank you. Hey, if you guys notice that somebody else joins us who hasn't been here, please let me know, or so we can write their name down somewhere and enter them to win the apron too. I think that would be a nice surprise because lots of people are not able to make the show, not, you know, because they don't want to, but just because of the timing of how things are. And I know many of you, you know, make efforts to be here live, and many make efforts just to be here after it's recorded, like, you know, just within the hour afterwards. So
yeah, thank goodness. That there have been times when I haven't been able to make it, and I go in and see that recording, and I'm always so thankful that it's available.
Me too, because I've actually gone back and rewatched, especially when we have guests on. Oh man, that has always made me so happy.
Yeah.
So happy. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I think the cross part of it is done for now.
Oh, that's what when Clarette says it reminds her of the song "The Old Wooden Cross."
Oh, very cool.
That's exactly where you were going, right?
Yeah. No. But I love that song. That was actually the song that they played at my grandfather's funeral. It was one of his favorites. So I love that song. But no, that's not where I was going. All right, so it looks like I've almost gotten it to where I want it to be here. I'm going to cover this. Oh! I don't know what that is. We might need to mute, though. Thank you.
That was Lisa's tool. E-tool.
Oh, well, you're over there. You're over there playing around, Lisa. Awesome.
I am. I'm sorry. I thought I was muted.
You're fine.
But I'm going to mute now and drive.
Okay, perfect. I love it when you guys play along, and then when you post what you've done, it always amazes me how we go in different directions, or how you take the same concept and do something totally different. I get very inspired by that, so I always appreciate when you guys play along and then you share, so please do that. And if anybody's watching the recording now and wondering what in the heck is going on, this is the extended version of Kraaft It Live. And we are nearing the completion of the mixed media canvas. All right, so I've just basically, now I'm just brushing over to kind of drag that white out some more. Okay, so do you see it?
Yep.
Do you see it upside down? All right, so there's the hill and the cross kind of bleeding into the hill.
Yes,
I'm so sorry that it's not a very good way to show this whole piece, but... Okay, we're going to let that dry. We're going to let that dry. So let me get the night so that we can work on the shadow of the cross. Any questions so far? Yeah, what the heck is wrong with you? I know that's one of the questions.
No. We're just enjoying.
I was wondering what was wrong with her.
I know you were. So I know. Hey, it's okay if there is somebody out there wondering that, because
I was like, I know there's a method to the madness kind of thing. I'm waiting.
So behind all of this, you can't really see it on screen. I'm looking, and you can't really see it. But back in here is all of that texture and everything that we did. All the piece was done, so it looks unified. Not like I intentionally put it where the cross was.
Right.
So that was part of it. The other part of it is, I love how there's texture even here in the sky. Once this dries, it'll be a little bit easier to see. But there's some texture in here. Uh-huh. There's how the flowers are kind of exploding away from. That was why the layout was this way, because I wanted it to really look like they're just kind of exploding away from this focal point here. So let's see. It's not dry, so let me dry it first, because I do not want to mess with the white.
Is the white paint or gesso?
It's gesso.
Okay.
It's gesso because the heavy body white that I wanted to use, I don't have anymore. I'm all out. This is all I had.
Gesso works good.
And so I grabbed Dina Wigley's gesso.
Yeah.
And I didn't want it to obliterate. See how you still see the purple and the green and the orange? No? You can't see that there?
Not really. When it's dry, I bet we'll be able to see it easier.
It's still purple. It's still orange. There's still blue. There's still green.
All right.
And that's on purpose. I wanted that white to just push it back and then right around the cross, really push it back. It's totally white. But there's still all that you can see.
Yeah, that's it. As it's drying, you can see it more and more.
Yeah. And in this area here, I'm going to put a scripture verse that I think is pretty cool for this time of year and for this image. So I don't know if I'll be able to do that before we're completely done here, but that's the end goal anyway. All right, so now I'm going to go in with my baby wipe and remove. I'm lightly doing this because I don't want to remove any paint. I just want to remove that black Stabilo pencil.
Oh, yeah.
Because that was just a guide to give me the idea of where all this was going to go.
Yeah.
Now, what will you do for the shadows?
I've got some night, Dina Wakely night.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Heavy body paint.
It's going to be pretty.
And I'm leaving that Stabilo, I'm not wiping it completely off. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's still there, but it's there in more of a shadow format. It's catching some of these edges and giving them a little bit more definition too.
Yeah.
Just another little fun part of it. We still have people here watching?
Oh, yeah. Beth is here. Cheryl's here. Almost everyone is still here.
All right, take Sylvia's job and do the romper room thing again, huh? I like it. No, I'm serious, I like it. Okay. It's not doing the lean back thing I wanted it to do, so hopefully I'll be able to get that with this. Let's just make our palette here. And I don't know how much of this you're going to be able to see, because I'm trying. I really am.
So Beth was able to come back.
Yay.
Yay. Yes, you have 21 viewers.
Wow, thanks, guys. 21 people to disappoint. No.
Stop.
All right, so we're just going to put in that shadow. That's all we're doing here. So hopefully it's not too boring.
Ooh. Miss Brewer says, please don't cover anymore while she's gone. She has to go scan something.
Please don't. I'm done covering. This is all that I'm doing is the shadow part. That's it.
And Nanette said, you did have 32 in the first hour.
Well, thanks, Nanette. You guys always impress me, showing up every week, hanging out, even with my crazy covering stuff up. I should put the warning sign back up for those that missed it, huh?
Might help.
You have to flash a warning sign all the time.
I did.
It's funny. Yeah. I didn't see the warning sign because I wasn't on when you first did it, apparently. But when I do the replay later, of the show itself, the AKP.
You will see it. Yep.
Yeah. Well, this has been interesting, and everything you do is always instructional, and you learn something from it. So it's all good.
All right, Jazzy. But see, I pay you to say things like
yes,
that. So
yes.
You guys always make me feel really good, but you also embarrass me a little bit with your kind words. But I appreciate it. I do. And for those who may have missed it, Lynn's, which is Ms. Brewer, I know you weren't here at the beginning. Several people weren't, but the warning symbol was totally and completely inspired by her. She just cracks me up. She sends me these incredible emails. I wish that I could share them because she needs to write a book is what she needs to do. They're just amazing.
She's a very funny lady.
Very much so. Definitely a highlight of my entire week. There's so many of you who send me such kind emails, and I really do appreciate every single message that I get from everybody. It's what keeps me going, because with sometimes this seems very one-sided, I'm over here talking, and that's why we love the After Crafter Party, and
you get to hear other people, it's a good thing.
Well, and what's going on? Like, what are you working on? It doesn't have to be about me. I don't care about that part of it. I want to know what you're doing. I want to know how you're inspired to create and the things that are happening for you.
Well, the last thing
you can see, but here's what mine is looking like so far.
All right, hold on. Let's see. We're going to put you on screen. Do you care?
No, that's okay.
All right, here's Lisa. Lisa's working on... Look at that!
Wonderful.
Oh, way to go, Lisa. See what I mean? Totally went another direction, but it's still amazing. I love this. Oh,
yeah.
You're going to have to post pictures of that in the community, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I will.
That'll okay. be good. That's cool.
Well, I already had a cross.
Even before I did?
Yeah, my lace was my cross.
Oh, my goodness. Did I talk about it having a cross on it? I was trying to keep that a secret.
No, you didn't say anything.
Oh, boy. Wowzers.
Great minds.
You just said Easter.
Well, I guess that makes it kind of obvious, but still, that's pretty cool. All right. I think I'm happy with that. That pleases me. All right. Let me wipe this up before I make a mess. All right. the last thing that I want to do before I put the verse on, and I don't know if we'll get to the verse before this is all done, but I think we need to add a little bit of green to the grass, and then we'll get to the last thing, okay? Two things at once here. I'm blow drying over here, and I'm cleaning a brush over here. Okay. So, let's get some of that darker green too. You can't see what I'm doing?
No.
Of course you can't, because no. I'm not on camera.
There you go.
There. Now we can see. Cool. Oh, the grass.
Yeah.
I didn't like how perfectly round that hill was. It needs to have a little bit more life. Not sure what's... Anna, this is
Marie,
hard.
She's working on her Easter egg.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
And I'm sure she'll post pictures. She's really good about posting pictures for us.
She sure is. Yeah, she sure is.
Okay. It's all about the layers, right?
Oh, yeah.
I apparently can't do this and talk at the same time. That's what I just realized just now. Okay, that part's done. So now, let's see if you can see it.
Yeah.
Look, it's like a hill upside down. Shameful. Isn't it shameful? All right, the final thing involves...
Yes, I've lost the chat, so
you
have to read.
All right, if you just lost the chat, it's probably because you need to click on the green bubble on the left that has the three men's heads in it. And then the chat should come back.
Thanks.
You are welcome. And those watching outside are going, what? Three men heads? What? Yeah, don't worry about it. It's not what you're having to worry about. Okay. Pink, orange, and yellow. This is the final step to what I'm going to do. If I can find the gloss, what did I do with that? Oh, boy. You know, the place isn't that big of a mess. What did I do with it? Oh, it's behind the water bucket. Okay. All right, so what I've got here is my soft gloss gel from Prima, and I've got Finbear's mica powders in tangerine, sunny yellow, and pink.
Ooh.
And we are going to add this to the flowers so that they will be bright, shiny, shimmery, and all that jazz.
Excellent.
And hopefully you'll be able to see it all. And then that's it. That's pretty much it, other than the scripture verse that I'm going to put on there. But I'm probably going to do that different because I need to print it up, I think. I think that's what I want to do. I want to print it and put it out. So, okay, this is super fun because these are mica powders, but they are really fun when you add soft gloss gel. They turn into like a glaze.
Uh-huh.
That way, and they're very reminiscent of silks, only, you know, you have to mix them yourself, type of thing.
So they're a dry powder?
They are in this current state, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so let me get the little pokey tool. Can you guys see this over here, what I'm doing, or is that off camera?
I can see it.
Okay. And I have a couple of different colors here. Yeah, that's going to be great. Okay. Now, I don't recommend you do this because it'll make a mess and everything, but do as I say, not as I do. I've just got myself a paintbrush. I'm going to dip into here. So there's some soft gloss gel on the end of my paintbrush. Then I'm going to dip directly into the powder, and now those two things will mix on here. And sometimes you might need to add a little bit more powder or a little bit more gel.
Miss Brewer says she's getting over the obliteration just and loving the cross.
Okay, well, this is good news, people. This is good news because I was really worried I would lose all hope of ever getting any of you back after this. So that's good news, everyone. All right. And even though I did go over these with white, which kind of, you know, defeats the purpose of the paint that was underneath, you can see it still coming through. And then when I add this over the top of that, it's just one more layer of fun.
Yeah.
And I'm just painting the centers right now with this pink because it's fun. And I'm thinking that I'm going to go over and add some orange and some yellow.
Oh,
but
yeah.
See, it's a very light, because it's more of a glaze than it is a paint.
Right.
So it's there, but the shimmer, when you put it in certain ways, is going to be amazing, mm-hmm. which is what I want. I want this to be very eye-catching. What's really sad about mixed media, I think, is that in order to truly appreciate it, you got to see it in person.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, seeing a picture of it doesn't really do it justice all the time, but especially watching it on a live video feed over the internet doesn't do it very much justice at all, actually.
The camera does give you enough that I can see the texture coming back up.
Good, very good. Okay, that's good to hear. Now I've switched to the tangerine, so we're going to add some of that tangerine in here. Oh, is Lynn's being funny again?
Miss Brewer, she says, it's like watching a vandal getting a bucketful of emulsion and chucking it over the Mona Lisa. Oh, my.
You crack me up, girl.
But Sue says, putting the color back, you know, coming back.
Yeah, well, that was my intention. I wanted these flowers to be much more vibrant and to have some shimmer and some attitude. And with this glaze, what's really cool when you're doing a glaze is that it settles where there's, you know, the valleys.
Yeah.
So it's great with these textured pieces because it's going to really make these flowers look much more dimensional.
They already are dimensional now.
What? Yeah. Say it again.
Definitely. I can see shadows with the flowers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep, they're all coming back to life.
Yay. See? I can do good. See?
Yeah.
Again, it was that there was an ugly stage where everybody, I'm certain, in the audience was going, what in the heck is wrong with this woman? But, you know, whatever.
We all knew that it was going to be good in the end.
Oh, did you? Okay, well, you have more confidence than I do, I think. That's what it is.
Yeah, all right. That must be. We just have faith in you, huh?
Okay. Now I'm just adding yellow to each of these end petals here. I don't know how much of this you guys want to stick around for. This is kind of a lengthy process. I didn't expect it to be. so lengthy, but I'm enjoying painting each of these petals.
Well, it's
interesting. Giving them their life.
It's interesting to just sit here and watch it come back to life as you're doing that. It's, you know, you can see all the texture and the. I'm loving this. I like this car. I like this way better than all the white being put
on. All right. I hear ya.
Oh, wow.
But it wouldn't be as impactful if I didn't do that white, though.
Is that why Sylvia's not here?
Yes, that's why. No, not at all.
I know, I'm joking.
Oh, I can't wait till I tell her that. Whoops.
I love the noise she makes when
the gasp, the heart attack that's taking place.
I know, it's too funny.
I thought about adding like glitter to the center of these, but I think I'm gonna pass on that. I think I like the
stop while you're ahead.
Yeah, it's that, and it's I really like the way this is turning out. I wasn't sure if they were going to have that the kind of effect I was hoping for, and they are. So this is, I love the color that's coming from this.
Oh, I do too.
I'm wondering if I should add some blue. What do you guys think? Should I add some blue into these flowers or just keep going with these three colors?
Oh, right, corn flowers.
Maybe.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, there's highlights of blue all over the place, you know.
Yeah.
I like the colors you're using right now.
All right, we'll stick with this then.
Yeah.
You heard it here. This is why you want to be inside the film strip, people, because you get to say so.
You get to say so.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Could you have used magicals for the same way that you used the mica powder?
I could have, but there's two things why I wouldn't choose to do that. One is because it's a water-based product, so when if I were to go over this, you know, if I decided I want to add something to it, I couldn't because the magicals would move.
Okay.
And then the other thing is because they are two-tone, I wasn't sure what I would get from them. With this, I knew this color would be this color, and it would be super shimmery and shiny. And this gloss gel would just make it pop and stay put.
Okay.
Which is what I wanted.
Thank you.
But magicals are awesome. I love them. Let's go with pink on the end of that.
Gosh, that pink sure is pretty.
More comments?
What is she doing? Well, apparently Kim has posted a cartoon somewhere. I'm not too sure because I haven't been paying attention now. But she's posted a cartoon somewhere, and I guess...
Probably Lynn's. Miss Brewer is Harry Farmer's daughter on Instagram, and I'll bet you anything that's where you can find it. If you're on Instagram under Harry Farmer's daughter,
okay. You
will find the... She has, and take a look at her Instagram feed, because I'm telling you what, that girl, she has posted a number of very incredible cartoons that I can't even put words to how awesome they are.
So what
I'm creating a book from what she's done. I'm sorry, go ahead.
You said, what is she in under Instagram? What's her?
Harry Farmer's daughter, all one word.
Okay.
Harry like hair. You know,
okay.
Fuzzy.
Oh, dear goodness.
Dear goodness?
Dear goodness.
I'm not quite sure I can explain that one.
Yeah, no need. I'll look at it when we're done. I promise. But take a look at the rest of her feed. She's got some incredible pictures there. There's even one of our dearly beloved Michael in a bathtub. Careful what you say in the comments on this show, people.
There's a bikini on a person that just, well.
Oh. Yeah.
Andrew, oh. Bikini, and wax.
I see. Gotcha. Careful what you say. I'm serious.
Exactly.
Harry Farmer's daughter. Oh, wow, that's funny.
Thanks, Linz. That's great, great entertainment right there. We appreciate it. This show has brought out some of the best in a lot of people. I'm just grateful people keep sharing it because it's loads of fun. All right, I am just about done with these flowers, I think.
I was amazed at the stamps that the gals made with their...
Right, and they're going to do a carving fest, an all-day live event, just like this, we're in.
I can't do it. You know, my hands, I have arthritis in my right hand, and I'm right-handed, so I've tried the little carving. My daughter does some, but I can't do it. But I sure love watching the stuff that they make. Those faucets that Sylvia made?
Yeah.
Holy mackerel. They are incredible.
Incredible. I mean, agreed. Yeah. Agreed. Okay, now I'm probably off camera now.
Gorgeous. Oh, they look gorgeous. Ah, love those.
I'm sorry if I'm off camera, guys.
You're on camera.
Okay. You're there.
For a minute, anyway. Wait till we get to this next one here.
We can see all the flowers.
Yeah. Even down here?
Yes, we can see from the
okay
hillside to right where your wrist is.
Okay.
And that's a particularly good shot because you can see how shiny they are and how glossy, you know.
Good.
It's really nice. Yeah.
So what I will do with this piece is I'll probably hang it in my house for a while, but I am going to take some pictures and put it up on Society 6 if anybody's interested.
Oh, good. Yes. I was going to ask you if you're going to do that.
I don't know if I should do tote bags and stuff like that. That part of it is kind of crazy to me, but I always do if somebody requests it. But
the print I'd like.
So you get to choose what you want them used as. So many different things that they offer.
Yeah, I just have to, not everything I can because it depends on the, the word is... It's not necessarily the resolution, but you have to make different sized photos for each of those objects, and sometimes like the cropping doesn't work well with a particular image. You know? Sandra has been phenomenal at being able to do all that with hers. She's really good. But photos are not my thing. I don't do the whole photograph thing, so I have a photographer that I could ask her to do some of that stuff, but like she doesn't have another job, right?
Yeah.
Just work on my stuff, please.
Stop what you're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, look at how springy they are. Okay, I think this is going to be better, but I have to move this stuff over.
Yeah, just look at that. Oh my gosh.
I love the sparkle.
Isn't that lovely? Yes.
All right. You probably can't see what colors I'm choosing, but hopefully you'll be able to see me putting them on.
When
you
put them on, we'll see. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
You girls are doing a great job. Sylvia's going to be worried.
Oh, I'm sure she is.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, my.
She was funny about Michael being on the show and doing their job.
Was she?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Speaking of, she's going to be on the show at the end of the month. In case you guys didn't notice, she's going to do
more jewelry.
She's going to do a necklace, wire wrap necklace, and feature some beading and all kinds of stuff start to finish and end in a totally end piece.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's going to be good.
So you want to make sure you don't miss that. It's the last one of the month. The last episode of the month is the one she's going to do it on.
Yeah, that'll be cool. And so you'll just be able to sit back and watch.
I know, my favorite part.
I know, it'll be fun for you too.
Very much so. I have thoroughly enjoyed having guests on the show and being able to just sit back and watch them shine. I even consider
the beads make more sense now.
What?
The beads work better now.
The beads work better?
Yeah.
Good. You were wondering what the heck their purpose was, huh?
Kinda.
They do look mean.
We're almost done. For those who are wondering what the heck, how much longer can this go?
This is really pretty.
One of the things I've had a hard time with on Kraaft It Live is being able to share the entire experience from start to finish. I mean, it's hard in an hour to do it.
Oh, my God.
And getting things prepared ahead of time is, you know, sensible but not too fun.
Yeah,
it kind of kills them.
It's like you're in the moment as you're doing it, you know, and if you have to do all this preparation and it's just kind of fun. It's fun to see how somebody works their way through something. They're like, you know, okay, so I'm going to do this and then let's see maybe, you know, and it's, I kind of like that. It's sort of, you kind of see how someone's mind is working as they're pulling stuff together. I like that part.
Well, good. That's always been the whole point of Kraaft It Live. But at the same time, I also want to give you a completed work, because what's happened in the past is I do, you know, most of it, but you don't really see how it gets finished. And then I keep working on it either in After Crafter Party or even beyond that sometimes, where a lot of times where people are, you know, we're not able to hang out as long as it'll take, or we don't hang out at all that day or something, but I finish it up and I forget to take pictures and I forget to, you know, this is going to be good to share with folks what I did here, but you can't really stop what you're doing and do that. I'm not very good at it anyway.
Well, I think
really
this is
love nice. That.
This is so good. This is my hopes that at one point in my life, when I'm messing around with my art, as I put it, is that I start with a plan and can work with a plan and go through with it, because I tend to sit down and just start putting stuff on a page, you know, and I don't know where it's going or where I'm ending up with it, and sometimes it sits there for a week before I go back to it, you know, and think, oh, well, maybe I should do this, and, you know, I kind of just mess around with it. But I never have I found at the beginning that when I had a plan, that it never came up planned it.
Well, and then you're setting yourself up for a disappointment, yeah, it seems
exactly.
like.
Exactly,
yeah.
And I finally was like, I can't do it that way. I just need to sit down and do
well,
stuff.
I'll be honest with you. I've probably had years of just messing around. I mean, let's just see what this does.
Yeah.
That led me to being able to actually have a plan.
Well,
now I can do one or two pieces like this every so often where I have a distinct plan. I know what this is going to look like when I'm done, or pretty close to. I mean, honestly, this doesn't look quite like what I was aiming for, but it's close enough that I'm very pleased with where it's ended, you know?
Yes.
Sometimes.
Yes, so, well, then there's hope for me still.
Yeah, there's hope for all of us, I think. I think that's the key, is that we just keep playing. That's why Crafters Community is so much fun, because we just dive into whatever we're feeling, whatever we're thinking, whatever we happen to be into at this moment.
And, you know, spending a couple of hours watching someone like you doing this kind of thing, it's such a pleasure, you know. And then everything is like a learning experience. So I think it's all great. I love it.
Well, that's what it's been for me, too. I have really enjoyed being able to watch what the videos people post and the, you know, pictures and images and blog posts. And I don't comment on everything, but I definitely read most of what gets posted in the Crafters community on Google Plus, because I feel if you posted it, I might as well go look at it. And nine times out of ten, I learn something. So it's become a part of my education, as it were.
Oh, my goodness. So will you be able to read all the chat afterwards?
I will. Yeah, I definitely go in and read. I usually sit down with my feet up because I've been standing this whole time, so it kind of hurts.
Yeah.
So I put my feet up and then have myself a little cappuccino, and then I do all the little work that I have to do to make pictures and all the posting, and if I have a blog post to update, which I do, by the way, you guys, there is a blog post about this.
Good.
Out there, so I will update it with close-ups and so on and so forth. But
yeah, well, Miss Brewer says one of the things she says is, I really enjoying this pace as well. It feels like we are sat in the room together, drinking a beverage, chatting and arting.
Exactly. That's the whole point. Oh my gosh, look, oh my gosh, I wish you could see the whole thing.
Oh wow.
That's okay. I lied about that being the last thing. I'm going to do one more thing, okay, you guys?
Okay, but don't forget to Instagram it.
Yeah, we will definitely Instagram. Okay, so I've got this brilliant blue. It's called Summer Sky.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh.
And I don't know that I'm going to do them all, but I'm definitely going to hit some of them with that.
Oh yeah, that's pretty.
So I'm sorry that I lied to you guys that was it, but this is it.
Mm-hmm. Part of the mystery of art. Wow.
I also love how the gesso is drying. Other colors are peeking back through.
I totally agree. I think that makes a huge difference in how you feel about covering things up, for one thing, but two, the total effect of it. I really, you know, I'm isolating the background so that cross stands out, but it doesn't mean I don't want the background to be there anymore.
Well, I'm not too keen on that. How much white is showing, but again, if I saw it in person, it would be a different thing, I'm sure, you know? I mean, I understand why you put the gesso and the white back there, but it, I don't know, it just seems a little overwhelming. But again, if I saw it in person, I might not feel that way at all. I might be like, oh, I can see it, and it's more of a balance, I guess, than what we see on the screen, you know?
Yeah, unfortunately today nothing is sharing very well and it's driving me nuts, but
that's why seeing the finished piece will be awesome to see just how once everything is dried and set, how it's all a unified picture.
Yep.
Well, and the worst part is you guys aren't even seeing the whole darn picture at once either. That's
no.
Very frustrating. But at least we're all frustrated together, right?
But you can take a picture of it on your camera, right? You can take a picture of the whole thing.
Yeah, I'm going to do that right now. I'm actually going to climb up onto my stool. So if I fall down, you guys know why.
Be careful.
Oh, dear.
Yes, ma'am. All right. Here we go. Okay. And I'm going to take a picture. And it's really awesome that we're doing this live, because if I fall down, somebody can call 911.
Oh, 911, yes. I hear my call. I'm calling from Canada, but my friend has fallen.
Smile. Okay. And I'm going to take one for Instagram. And then we'll say goodbye. And remember, everybody who was here, your name was entered to win the apron.
Oh.
And we'll post tomorrow who the winner is, okay? So we'll post it in the community, and I'll post it on Instagram. I'll post it everywhere that I possibly can. Oh, this looks so pretty. Okay, here it goes to Instagram, everybody.
Oh, good, because I'm looking
for... Oh, yes, okay.
And Facebook and Twitter. All right, and we're going to say goodbye. So thank you very much to Jane and Lisa and to Chandler. Christian, I appreciate you guys all being here. Thank you all so very much. I hope that you enjoyed it.
Fun.
And everybody, oh my gosh, there's 19 of you out there. Everybody who stayed to stick around and watch this, I appreciate every single minute of you being here. I'm sorry you can't see the whole thing, but I promise it's on Instagram. And I'm going to go make it public on Facebook, so if you don't follow me on, if we're not friends on Facebook, you'll still get to see it. So hang on. Talk to you all later.
Bye.
Thank you so much.
Bye.